If you're glad to be here, put your hand on it like this. I'm glad. So glad.
Praise the Lord. This is the day that the Lord hath made, and yes, we will rejoice and be glad in it. So glad you tuned in today. Amen. And on this Tuesday night Bible study, amen, as we go into the Word of God, woman to woman, amen, this is our fourth series. And on tonight, we will be talking about Sarah and Hagar. Amen. But before we do that, let's go to the throne of grace. Gracious Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for this opportunity to go into your Word on tonight, to share the Word of God. We ask, Lord, that the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart is acceptable in thy sight. We pray, God, for those that are grieving, those that are mourning, that you would comfort in the name of Jesus. Those that are sick, Lord, we pray, God, that you would send your healing. Oh, God, we pray for families, that you would unify them in the name of Jesus. Lord, we know there's nothing too hard for you, and we're looking to you for all things. And we count it as done even now in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen, amen. I would also like to say we are 1 week away from voting. If you have not registered to vote, make sure you register to vote and make sure that your voice is heard, amen, at the polls on next week, Tuesday. Amen. We are living in some troubling times, amen, and we know that God is in control. As we have been stating in our series of Woman to Woman, every woman that we spoke about for the last 3 weeks, we ended in saying, with all that happens, no matter what the situation is, God is in control. Amen. And on last week when we were talking and we had stated that how you need to look to Christ, knowing that not what necessarily what you're going through right now, but know that God is going to change your situation. And as we look into the Word of God on tonight, amen, woman to woman, amen, so glad you tuned in on today, amen. Why don't you call someone and let them know that the Ark of Deliverance Revival Center is on the air and there's a word, yes, just for you. So we'll start reading in Genesis, the 16th chapter, and we'll start reading at verse 1 through 4, and it reads, "And Sarah, Abraham's wife, bare him no children. And she had an handmaiden, an Egyptian, whose name was Hagar." Amen. So our women to women's topic on tonight is Sarah and Hagar, two women. Amen. And next verse says, "And Sarah said unto Abraham, Behold, now the Lord hath refrained me from bearing. I pray thee, go into my handmaiden. It may be that I may obtain children by her. And Abraham hearkened to the voice of Sarah. And Sarah, Abraham's wife, took Hagar, her handmaiden, the Egyptian, after Abraham had dwelt 10 years in the land of Canaan, and gave her to her husband Abraham to be his wife. And he went in to Hagar, and she conceived. And when she saw that she had conceived, her mistress was despised in her eyes. And Sarah said unto Abraham," we'll jump down to verse 5, next verse it says, "But Abraham said unto Sarah, Behold, thy handmaiden, it is in thine hand to do as it pleaseth thee. And when Sarah dealt hardly with her," the scripture says, "she fled from her face." That's oftentimes, we have two women here, and in the Old Testament, it was customary that that type of relationship, the handmaiden, you know, it was a blessing to have children, and because Sarah could not have children, but God made a promise to Abraham and to Sarah that he was going to be the father of many nations, and if Abraham was going to be the father of many nations, what did that make Sarah? The mother of many nations. And things didn't go the way Sarah thought that they should go. So in Bible days, you know, they allowed them to let their handmaiden have children, and she had her handmaiden Hagar to go in to have a child because she desperately needed and wanted a child. And so often we as women desperately want certain things, and we put our hand in it and in an attempt to help God out. Listen, God does not need any help. And so when Hagar became pregnant, and I could see, can you imagine Sarah looking at her as she's walking through the tent and going about her day, and as the bump in her belly begins to be pronounced, jealousy set in. So then she said, she was mean to her. She began to be evil to her, to treat her without respect. And so what did Hagar do? Hagar left, she fled. And the Bible tells us, and the angel of the Lord found her by a fountain of water in the wilderness, and by the fountain in the way to Sur. And the angel of the Lord said unto her, listen to this, return to thy mistress and submit thyself under her hands. Can you imagine that? That had to be a hard pill for Hagar to swallow. Go back to the woman that's treating me wrong. Go back to the woman that gave me to her husband and then don't want me to be a part of the family any longer. And you want me to go back to her? The word of the Lord said, go back to her. And not only did he say, go back to her, he said, submit to her. That's a hard pill to swallow. But the angel of the Lord didn't leave it right there for Hagar. He told her, he says, and a blessing is given to Hagar and a promise concerning Hagar and her son that she was going to have. The word of God let her know, you're going to have a son, and his name will be called Ishmael. And in essence, she was saying, the Lord has heard my afflictions. The Bible tells us many are the afflictions of a righteous. But what does it tell us? But the Lord does what? He delivers us out of it all. And I'm reminded of Jesus, how when he was reviled, he didn't revile again. So the angel was saying unto Hagar, go back and submit yourself to your handmaiden, your mistress, I'm sorry. And when you submit yourself, and you're going to have a child, and he told Hagar, your seed is going to be multiplied exceedingly. Listen, oftentimes we find ourselves in situations and in places where God tells us to go back to the ones that did us harm. Go back to the ones and treat them with love, to the ones that misused us. Go back to the ones, because I got a promise, not just for you, but also for your offspring. And so it was. Amen. Amen. She went back to, praise be unto God, she went back home, so to speak. And when she went back home, she submitted herself, amen, to Sarah. And then we jump down to the 21st chapter of Genesis. And it says, in verse 2, it says, for Sarah conceived and bare Abraham a son in his old age, at the set time of which God had spoken to him. Listen, God has a set time for everything. Even though over 10 years had passed, and Hagar had a son for her, but it wasn't Sarah's. It was Sarah's son, but it wasn't one that she birthed. But in the process of time, God brought his promise back to Sarah and to Abraham, and Sarah conceived and she bore a son. The scripture says, and Abraham called the name of his son that was born unto him, whom Sarah bare to him, Isaac. Amen. And the scripture goes on to tell us how when Sarah saw, at the time of weaning, they had a big celebration, and Sarah saw Ishmael mocking Isaac. And the Ishmael, the Egyptians, Hagar's son, and she was mocking him. And so Sarah said to Abraham, get her out of here. Pastor, you know how we are with our own children. Even though that was her son at the time that she helped to raise, she helped, you know, it was also Abraham's son, it was her husband's son. But at this point, she was mocking my flesh and blood. And she says, put her out. Put Hagar and Ishmael out. And this thing grieved Abraham, the Bible lets us know. And Abraham did as his wife instructed him to do, as much as it grieved him. But God spoke to Abraham, and God told Abraham, this is still your seed. This is still your seed, and because it's your seed, he's going to be blessed. And so it was. Abraham made a package, and he got the bondwoman, and he gave him a bottle of water, and he gave him a sack of bread, and he sent them by their way. And in sending them by their way, they were in the wilderness. And while in the wilderness, after he had rose up early in the morning, God, they were in the wilderness, and the water ran out, and their food ran out, and she set her son Ishmael under a bush, under a tree, because she did not want to see her son die. And she went afar off, and as that son began to cry, God heard the cry of that son. Listen, oftentimes we may feel like we've been put out. Oftentimes we may feel like we've been set aside. Oftentimes, even by the ones that we love. But God, in his mercy and in his grace, God sees you. Oh, I don't care what situation you're in right now, sister, woman. It does not matter, man of God. It does not matter if you felt like you've been put to the side, that you've been put out in the wilderness. God hears you. The scripture lets us know his ear is not heavy that he cannot hear. His hand is not shortened that he cannot save. But God heard the son's cry. And when God heard the cry of that son, amen, God, the word of God says, God said unto her, he said, God opened her eyes, and when she saw a well of water, she went and filled the bottle with water and gave her son to drink. And God was with the son, that lad, and he grew, and they dwelt in the wilderness, and the scripture lets us know that he became an archer. Amen. And Hagar, whose name means forsake or to retire, who bore a child for an infertile woman at her own request. Today we would call it possibly a surrogacy. This woman was cast out, but God did not cast her out. When Sarah would not get pregnant for a while, even though God had promised her that she would, she decided to take things into her own hands. And too often, God has given us a promise. And when we don't see that promise coming to fruition, we take things into our own hands. But let me tell you something, how good God is, even in the midst of that. Even though she took things into her own hands, even though she allowed Hagar to go into her husband, even though she did what, contrary to what she should have did, that did not stop the fulfillment of God's promise to either one of the women. Listen, you know, at first glance, when we see Sarah, we see her in the embodiment of fear and doubt. Oftentimes, when things don't happen the way we think it should happen, we get fearful. But the Bible tells us God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of love and of power and of a sound mind. Amen. She doubted God, because when God told her they were going to have a children, what did she do? She laughed. And oftentimes when we don't see the promises of God come alive in our lives, especially in, it didn't happen this year. Well, what about next year? These were years, over 10 years that had passed. Amen. And she was trying to help God out. Listen, God don't need no help. He don't need help from you. He don't need help from me, because he's God. He's sovereign. And he knows what to do, how to do it, and how to get it done. Hallelujah. And at first sight, when we see Sarah, we would think, well, what could we learn from Sarah? Amen. She doubted God. She had a promise. She didn't wait on God. But that's what we can learn from her. That's one lesson that we can learn from Sarah, to wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thy heart. What the scripture says, wait, I say, on the Lord. Because no matter what comes up against us, we need to know that with God, all things are possible. And God is not limited, hallelujah, amen, to the laws of biology or physics. I'm going to say that again. God is not limited to the laws of biology or physics. Even though Sarah was barren, all it took was the right time. Amen. God, we also didn't say he may not come when you want him, but he's right on time. God had a time set for Sarah and Abraham to have that promised child. And so it was. They had that promised child. And God's promised child, hallelujah, amen, she was able to see it grow. Even though in the midst of it, she put her hands in it. So if you're going through a time and you don't see God's hand working things out, I'm reminded in Isaiah, the 43rd chapter in the second verse, and it says, when thou passest through the waters, I'll be with you. While you're going through your trial, while you're going through your tribulation, while you're going through the test, God said, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. And when thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flames kindle upon you. Amen. Oh, praise be unto God. Even though Sarah doubted God and she devised her own way of realizing the promise, amen, and she had Hagar to go in to her husband, that did not stop the fulfillment of God's promise to Abraham and Sarah. Sometimes we put our hands in it, but that will not stop the fulfillment of God's promise to you. Listen, we mess up sometimes. Yes, we mess up sometimes. And just because we mess up does not stop God's fulfillment or God's promise in our life. Oh, thank you, God. Thank you, God. Here we find a woman who was given a promise and tried to force the promise, then tried to get rid of what she forced. How many times have you done that? God told you something, and you're going to, because it didn't happen the way you thought it should have happened, you're going to try to work it out yourself. And sometimes we've done that, and oftentimes, it all falls apart. But I'm here to let somebody know on today, even though things have felt falling apart, God's promise still will be manifested in your life. Oh, thank you. Somebody give God a praise. Amen. Amen. God will fulfill his promise. Despite the misguided efforts of Sarah, despite the misguided efforts of Hagar, God's promise was still fulfilled. And because the misguided efforts that we make, God's promise is still going to be fulfilled in your life. Yes, it was wrong for Sarah to mistreat Hagar. Yes, it was wrong for Hagar to run. What the scripture tells us, having done all to stand therefore. Hagar ran from the presence of her handmaiden, but God told her to go back and submit. And sometimes that's what God wants us to do. Just go back and face it. Whatever you're going through, whatever that's ailing you, God wants you to face it. But when you face it with humility. Don't be boisterous and say, I'm back, I'm here, I ought to be. No, but God wants you to be humble. Face it with humility and watch God work in your behalf. Thank God. Yes, God worked through their situations. And not only was Sarah blessed, but Hagar was blessed. Because from Hagar, her son Ishmael, which is from the nation of the Ishmaelites, and he was still blessed. He was still, because he was born of the father Abraham, who God had promised him, and his seed was blessed. So despite how the seed came about,
Despite how the seed came about, God still blessed the seed. Hallelujah. Because God's word is yea and amen. Listen, God said, my thoughts are not like your thoughts. My ways are not like your ways. And oftentimes, because things happen in an unconditional or ways in which we didn't think it should happen, that does not stop the blessings of God. Because with blessings, he will bless you, his word tells us. Because he was the son of Abraham, he would bless him. And because we are of Abraham's seed, despite sometimes we are misguided, despite sometimes we put our hands in it, despite sometimes we overstep our authority as women. But God still hears us, even as he heard Hagar, even as he heard Sarah's cry. So when we mess up, when we get our hands in it and don't allow God to work it out, God's promise still will be fulfilled in your life. But if you humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, listen, in due season, he will exalt you. But as women, let's learn how to be humble before the Lord. Amen. Let's learn how to know and to realize that God is in control of everything that happens in our life. Submit your ways to God. Submit your thoughts. Submit your life to God. And when you submit your life to God, you'll see every promise that God has made for us, to us, will come to pass if we submit our ways. Hallelujah. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you on this evening for your word. We thank you for an opportunity to share your word of these two women, women that we can learn from. Hallelujah. What can we learn, Lord God? How to be submissive to you, how to submit our ways to you, how not to doubt you, how not to fear, because your word declares, he that doubteth in his heart is damned already. But we thank you for the promises that you have made to us as believers. We're heirs and joint heirs with Christ Jesus. We are the head and not the tail. We are above and not beneath. And during these trying times, Father God, we pray that you would continue to walk with us, to lead us, to guide us, to direct us. In Jesus' name we pray. It is so. Amen. God bless you is my prayer. Listen, I want you to know that no matter how much you put your hands in the middle of it, hallelujah, and you think things are messed up and it will not work out, if God has made a promise to you, he will bring that promise to pass, because God is not like man. He does not lie. He cannot lie. He will bring to pass every promise that he has promised you in your life. God bless you.